dead center of the world, and it's a radial point now. It's a flat plate that floats on water. And then it breaks up. This is the Mediterranean. So this is the Nile, right here. This is Crete. There's the Minoan Labyrinth. This is Italy. And then this is another, this is a similar map. And some of these I cut apart. So when I do the maps, I'm really interested in form as I'm interested in form first, like with all the other ones upstairs. But then the history starts to impose itself. I'll read history with my iPad books while I'm painting. And then sometimes there's the sections I can't violate and we can't paint them out because it's too important for some reason. Like I've got this historical hang up on something. And this is the oldest one. I just put stripes on it. I just wanted to look kind of decorative. But this ET looking thing, this is a world map from 740.
Do you weather your maps sometimes? Or is it
just with washes of acrylic. But this is Spain. This is the Rome. This is France. This is Italy. These are the Alps. This is Sicily, Corsica, Sardinia. This is the Adriatic Sea, this is Greece, this is the Bosphorus, this is India, this is the Nile. So if you turn it this way, this is north, this is the Mediterranean, this is Crete. Or Crete and Cyprus. But someone planned their ambition on this. This was reality. You know, not really, it's so flat, almost comical, but yet decisions are made. And then this is a later map, this is part of one, and then I cut these things up, and so it's kind of. This is the same map used twice. This is the same map repeated here and then painted into. This is Iceland, Ireland, England. English maps all look south. This is nothing north. They all look south. They're all down here. All the English maps in the Middle Ages, the early part of the Renaissance, this is where England is. The rest of the world is this way. So you cross the channel, here's London. Across the channel, you ask questions, I guess. And here's the Seine, here's Paris. You go through France, this is Lake Leman, and into the Rhone, and across the Alps, you're in the Po Valley in Italy. This is the Po, here's the Po. And then this is the Apennines to Rome. The Tiber River is way out of scale. And it flows towards Sicily for some reason. But I guess if you